Today I've got two tops to show you from the same pattern. It is a woven dolman design, but with a few extra details. I think it's super pretty. Buttons on the back and a few more other details. I've shown you a sneak of the print, but I've also made one in solid. Lots to see today, so stay with me. Hi sewing friends, I'm Karina from liftingpinsandneedles.com. Welcome to this channel that is all about sewing, limitless sewing. Today I have a few dolman tops to show you, made out of woven, designed for woven fabrics. And if you've been watching, last week I made an episode that was dedicated to full bust adjustments on dolman tops, woven of course. And I've shown you there a few scenarios and already did a few full bust adjustments on some of the patterns that I had that I was planning to sew. So if you haven't seen that, you can go ahead and look. This will only be relevant if you are a sewing C cup and above. Most patterns, at least this one, was drafted for a B cup. I think dolman styles are especially sensitive to bust fitting issues just because of the design, that there's actually no armhole and the sleeve is sort of integrated, not like this where there is a sleeve and an armhole and the shape can better be adjusted to the bust in this way. You don't see any gathers or like extra fabric around in this area. But on a dolman, if your bust is not fitting in there properly, you will have lots of pleats and things there. So I thought, why not improve the patterns that I have, transform them to a C cup. So in this specific pattern, you will see some bust studs there that are not part of the original design, at least for this view of this pattern. I'm talking about the Bonnie top from Style Arc. Now in this pattern that's designed for wovens, it's not just one top in there. There's two different views, but they share in common the rounded neckline, the button down feature on the back, not on the front. And then view A is sleeveless. The armhole is finished with facings. It's not a tight fitting design or loose, has an amount of ease that is appropriate. And the side seams are just sewn normally and hemmed. There are side bust studs in this view. Now view B is looser fitting. The neckline is also finished with a facing, but this is the dolman style that doesn't have a bust stud that I have added one onto. There are side slits, you know, on the side seams. I knew that a dart would improve the fit for me 100%. I've mentioned that this is for woven fabrics, right? It's not for knit fabrics. So you can choose a vast variety. If you want a more structured look, you can use cotton or linen. It's not my preference. The other recommendations there are rayon and crepe, and those give you a softer, flowier look, and that is usually what I'm drawn to. So the two tops you'll see today, one is made with 100% rayon in a beautiful, beautiful print you won't see anywhere else. And the other one is made in a solid, but the solid has something extra too. It's not just a plain solid. And that one is a crepe. When you look at the sizing, this one comes from sizes 4 to 30. I bought a multi-size option from sizes 4 to 16 on the pattern. You can choose other size ranges. You know, it's quite good. I think from 10 to 22 and then from 18 to 30. View A, I mentioned, didn't have that much positive ease. I mean, it still does, but not as much as view B. Looking at the website, at the size chart for my size, my body measurements compared to the finished garment measurements on the pattern, if I had chosen my body size, which at the moment is a 14 and then a 16 at the hips, I would have ended up with about 10 inches of positive ease at the bust and about 10 inches of positive ease at the hips, which I think is an extreme amount. I don't want that much positive ease in my garments. No, like no, ever. So I started comparing, because I had all the sizes printed out there anyway. I can't turn sizes off because there's no layers. I did some flat pattern measurements, I did some comparisons, and I ended up making a size 12. So for view B, I went down two sizes, and that ended up giving me about 6 inches of positive ease at the bust and about 3.5 at the hips, which I find is appropriate for what I like, for how I like to dress. I don't like to dress oversized, too relaxed feet. I just don't like that. I also don't like to dress too fitted, depending on the style. So I think for this one, I got away with making a 12 instead of a 14 to 16. For view A though, the sleeveless one that I haven't made in this opportunity, I wouldn't have dropped down two sizes. I would have just probably made a straight 14 without needing to blend to a 16 at the hips. This was a super fun project to sew. It's not the typical, like just shoulder seams and side seams, finish the neckline. No, there's a bit more things going on here. In Up Close and So Personal, you'll see a variety of sewing construction for this one. The most important change I'm making is that I am not doing the facings on this neckline. I'm doing the neckline with bias tape. that are made from the same fabric. And you're gonna see how I've done that. It's super easy and you can do it too. More pieces to this dolman top, but I have eliminated a few, just the facings basically that go on the neckline. So this is the back, and on the center back, it's not on the fold, there is an area that needs to be interfaced because this top has a button down feature on the back. So you've seen me do this before where I fuse the strip of interfacing onto the fabric right on the edge on the selvage before cutting out the pattern piece. That's what I've done to help it conserve its length and shape and everything. So that's on the back. Up higher on the necklines, you can see a black strip of interfacing there. And you've seen me do that as well. I cut a long strip, quite narrow, 3/8, and I fuse it on while the paper pattern is on there. And that's how I make sure I conserve the same shape and length and it doesn't deform. And I do that on both sides. So that is replacing stay stitching. And I find for rayon, it really conserves the neckline. It much better than stay stitching would. And I've done the same with the front over there. The neckline, I did drop it down by 1.5 inches, which is a conservative amount. I wouldn't want to drop it anymore. You can see this front neckline here on the forward. I've got it aligned along one of these lines of the cutting mat. And you can see here, when I redrew and dropped my neckline, you can see that on the center front, I extended it pretty flat, right along the line for about 1 inch. And then the curve starts. That will ensure that when you actually open this up, you won't end up with sort of like a V neckline. If you do the curve like right to the point here, you end up with a V neckline. And then the neckline just doesn't look right. And when you put bias binding, it just doesn't work. But having it done like that, where you keep the center pretty much on a straight line, you can see that the neckline is really curved and how it's supposed to be. So just be careful when you're raising or lowering necklines, that you keep the center front flat for about 1 inch, and then from there you start curving up to the top there. I didn't modify the back, I just modified the front. This fabric has an unusual type of print. It was sort of like a border print. I left most of the print down to the hem, and the shoulder area on the top is just mainly black. So this pattern has these epaulets that go on the shoulders, and I made sure to cut these from areas of the fabric that did have print. Because when I put these there, I do want that contrast there. I think it'll look really pretty instead of just doing a black epaulet. This is an almost completed top and so easy to put together. Just shoulder seams, side seams. There's a little slit here on the side. So I've serged the edges separately. I've pressed up a little hem. I've done little mitered corners. And these are the center backs. This is where the strip of interfacing was fused at the beginning. And on the edge, at 3/8 of an inch from the raw edge, I just did a guide stitch, then pressed that in. And then on the edge of that interfacing, I pressed it in again. And that forms the band that is going to have the buttons, and on both sides. The front is just one piece. There are side bust darts there that were generated with full bust adjustment. And I have pressed up the hems for the sleeves, 3/8 of an inch, serged the edges. So basically all that's left to do now is finish this neckline that's raw. You can see I've already stabilized the edges. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to put bias tape here. The original pattern has a facing, but I didn't want to do a facing. From scraps, I made a bit of bias tape from the same rayon. By stabilizing this, I know I'm not going to have a wobbly, stretched out neckline. And I'll just go ahead and pin this on and show you. I've got the neckline here. This is one of the back pieces. Here's the interface side, and the first fold at 3/8, and then the second fold, unfold it. And then on that fold where the interfacing is, you need to fold it onto itself, right sides together. And now take the bias tape that you have, one that you made or store-bought one. Just grab the edge and put it a little beyond that so it stays underneath. You don't need to go all the way to the edge. And then just pin there again. And then just keep pinning this along the edge of the whole neckline, right sides together. Here you can see the interface bit that I did to stabilize this and help it stay in shape. So we'll just pin this all the way around to the other side, and on the other side will be the same. I'll actually have it ready and already pinned onto itself. You can see, fold it right sides together. And I've shown you something similar like this with V necklines, where you have a V at the front. This is a rounded neckline and this is on the back, but the concept is the same. So I'll have that ready for when I get to this part, and then the bias tape will reach up to there. So the bias tape is all pinned from one edge to the other, and I'm going to sew on that first crease line right there all along, starting from there, from the edge, because that's going to close that corner there. And then when we flip it, it'll be all nice and neat. Now that this is sewn everywhere, the neckline is pretty curved in all places. So I'm just going to go ahead and snip all around. I've got that all snipped, and you can see on one of these ends, if you flip this on the inside, it's going to be super neat, and the bias tape is going to come from behind it like that. And I'm going to understitch, not from the whole point, just from there, keeping the seam allowance towards the bias tape, so underneath the bias tape, and understitch all that. And then when you flip it, it'll be understitched, and then I can just hand baste that on and then sew it by machine. This is the back of the top, and I've got the button area all hand basted, the neckline, everything, because I'm going to sew that and the hem in one go. I knew this top has buttons down the back as a design, and my fabric had print in a sort of different way, where there was print on some areas and black on some areas. Fortunately, on the side that has the button holes that will cross over this side, it's just black. That means that the buttons that I put on are going to be seen. The button feature will actually be a button feature on the back, and not just the buttons camouflaged within these colors, you know. I've made a mark there about 3/8 down, no, probably 5/8 down from the edge with chalk, and measured how much I have from here to the bottom. It's already been hemmed, so I have 55 centimeters, and I want to divide that by 6 because I have 6 buttons. 55 divided by 6 is 9.1. I'm basically going to have a button every 9 centimeters, 3 3/4 ish. So it's very easy to mark, and I've just put a pin there on every single place where there's going to be a button. So I have the same amount between each button, and then at the bottom there's a little bit extra, but that's fine. I actually need 8 buttons for this top. I have 6 at the back, and then on these epaulets here on the shoulder tabs, I would need 2 more. And yeah, I'm just going to put 2 black ones here on the top. These 2 are going to be black. No one will ever see them because I have my hair and I always wear my hair down. And then I'll have the coral buttons there and there and there. That's the best thing I can do. This is the shoulder seam. That's the neckline. And there is a little mark on the pattern that I've marked in blue there. And this is where you just get this, align it along that mark, and then stitch it down. That'll be the same for both sides. On the other side, it looks like just a little rectangle, and I'm glad this is black because it's really discreet. But if it was a print, this thing is going to come over and cover that anyway, so you won't see it. And I'll just stitch my button there, and that's how that is finished. I'll show you the print one first. This is a fabric I bought in Brazil. I'm sure it's going to be very difficult for you to find a print like this. It's got me written all over it. It's got black background and then these huge prints. And I made sure to place my pattern pieces with most of the black up here around the shoulders and the neckline. And it happens the same at the back. And then I left all the print down towards the mid section and the hem. I did this because of something aesthetic here. Any dolman style might make this area of the body look wider, might, just because it's just one continuous piece, right? There's no sleeve and armhole. So by having the darker color on the top, I want to counteract that effect. That is how I thought it out anyway. Have most of the black here on the top and then just have all the colors down there. And I made sure to have none of these actually hitting my bust. They are sort of flowing over one half of me because the other side is mainly black. This is epaulets, like they call it, but it is just a shoulder tab. And you saw how I've sewn that on inside and just flipped it out. I didn't do a buttonhole there. I just sewed the button on because, yeah, what for? I won't be unbuttoning this. This is optional, you know. If you didn't sew this, you would just have a normal dolman sleeve. But I wouldn't recommend because this sleeve opening is super wide and it would just look floppy in my opinion. I think this is what gives it the something extra and the like the detail of the top. So I wouldn't want to get rid of it. So I like that. Rounded neckline, I dropped it by 1.5 inches and you saw how I did that. I thought the original was just a tad high for my liking. And you can see the bias tape finish in there. Everything's been understitched and you know the way I sew. Everything was hand basted first. The integrated facing and the hem and the slits, they were all done in one continuous go and I've done that before. Little slits there. It is a simple top, you know, it's not got 1,000 details. If I timed myself, it probably took me about 2.5 hours to make. And you know, I'm not the fastest of sewists, although you might think I sew fast. I actually don't sew fast at all because I take my time to get, you know, the best result I can to show you a nice looking project. So that is the back there. You can see the integrated facings. I have serged the side seams separately to assist making the slits easier. I have done tiny mitered corners there on each of these corners, which is always super fun and I love that. It's got a small hem on the sleeves, just 3/8, and the neckline finish like that. I'm sure I wouldn't like to do the facing. Look, I have nothing against facings. I just don't like facings on rayons. I don't know. I just find doing bias tape finish so much easier by this point. And it just looks so much better and it's less bulky. You won't have anything flapping around inside. And when you try to top stitch facings down, I know 99% of people that sew won't baste that on by hand first to make it right. And then when you just sew it with a machine, it'll end up rippling. And I see a lot of complaints about facings, about them not looking right. And it's just a bit of extra time that they take to get right. I think bias tape finishes turn out so much better if everything is done, you know, nicely, using a small seam allowance to sew the bias tape to the neckline, snip, understitch, flip. I hand baste it all, then I sew it, and you know, that gives a really smooth finish. For facings, you would need to do sort of the same, but you add the bulk of a wider piece that's interfaced. You know, it's just my point of view. I have nothing against facings, and you will see me do them here and there with other types of fabric. But not with rayon. I did have button issues and I have 2 black buttons on the top because I didn't have enough of these coral ones and I did want the buttons to stand out. I didn't want to put just black buttons everywhere because what's the point? And they look pretty. So I'll leave these 2 there until I can go to a shop someday and buy 8 coral buttons and then I'll just swap them all out. You know, I don't mind doing that at all. This is the first bonnie top I made as per the pattern. It's got a front that's cut on the fold. It's got 2 little slits on the side, super neat. My hem is smaller than the pattern because I thought it was gonna end up being too short if I did the depth of the hem they had, so I just made it smaller and that's fine. At the back we have buttons. You probably won't see, but there is a dart there that was generated with the full bust adjustment. And I think it improves the fit on the side so much. although there's still excess heat on this part because this is a really wide sleeve opening. I still think that that is amazing and makes such a better fit. This is a round neckline that has been lowered 1.5 inches, as you saw, and it's nice and round. It's not pointing to the bottom like a sort of like a V. And you saw how I did that to achieve a really nice round neckline. Super nice. And we have those little epaulets here with the contrast color button to match the flowers. So nice. I really like that. And you know, the pattern placement here, I don't have a specific flower right on my bust. I have black area here, I have random flowers there. I had button problems. I needed 8 buttons, I only had 6. So the first 2 buttons at the back there are black. But I have long hair and I never tie up my hair because I get headaches. No one will know those are black, only you, because my hair will 100% cover them. And then below that we have the other buttons that are coral. I don't think the button down feature is that apparent at the back. That's why the next one you're gonna see has them on the front. Just a hint, I did make a little change there. I think it's a lovely top, super nice. It has something different with the sleeves. Easy to sew, as all the dolmans are. The bust darts makes it fit so much better. And it was fun. It was a nice step up from a basic dolman because of the button back, the slide slits, this detail. The bias tape finish on the neckline is very appropriate, very acceptable. You don't need to do the facings if you don't want to. The next one I made is the same pattern, the same everything. The only big change I made was transfer that extension of the pattern piece that has the button down feature on the back. You see the pattern piece for the back has little buttonhole marks all along, and then more paper and you fold it and all that. Always those buttonhole marks signify that that's the center of the pattern. So if I just fold all that extension away from the back, fold along the buttonhole marks, place it on the fold, I can just cut my back on the fold. If I measure from the buttonholes out to the edge of the paper, see what width that is, and then add that to the front piece, then I can cut the front with the button extension, but just on this side. So it's just like flipping certain amounts from the back to the front. I have made this in a brown crinkle chiffon that has embroidery. So you can see how transparent it is. Lightweight doesn't mean it drapes. So the embroidery and the crinkle factor make this a little bit more structured, although it is very lightweight and very sheer. So it's just the way that the fabrics are weaved, the way that they're going to flow. You can actually find thick heavyweight fabric that drapes beautifully, and it's just the way it's being weaved, you know. So this is a more structured but very lightweight fabric, and it is solid, but you can see all those embroidered flowers there and the crinkle factor. I think it's super pretty, and if I'm gonna make something solid that I usually don't want to do because I find them extremely boring, I'll try to find a solid that has something on it like this. So it's got the same thing there on the shoulders. I've used metal buttons, and you can see I've got all this down the front instead of at the back. Maybe with this one you can see my buster, it's not big. From a B to a C, the dart generated is not a big dart because it's not much of a difference. You know, it's different with a D cup or a double D cup, and they start getting bigger. With this one, I didn't sew the slits on the side. I just finished the side seam normally because I need to wear a cami underneath. I don't want the cami to be seen, you know, through the slit. So I made bias tape out of the same fabric and just did the same thing, just with a little bit more time. I think this one took maybe 3 hours to make, and the one in rayon took 2. I stabilized the neckline in the same way by fusing a little strip of interfacing. If you are on Patreon, Saffron and Orchid Tears, you will see how I did exactly all this transformation and practical aspects about this top. There's an extra video there on Patreon if you have access to that. For this one, I didn't do the slit here. I just closed it. I just sewed normal because it is sheer and I always have a cami. I might not want that cami to be seen on the side like this one. I don't want it to be seen, and I've still got enough room at the hips there. I think this is perfect for me. I wouldn't want it shorter than this. It's not boxy, but if I'd done the size that I had to, it would have been very oversized. I prefer this much better. Up closer, you can see maybe the texture of this fabric. It is very sheer, it's crinkled, and it's got some embroidery on it, on brown. Super love that. But I do need a cami 100%. I have a bust out there, and I think it helps a lot with not having extra fabric here on the side of the bust. So doing that is not a waste of time in my opinion, even though I did have the ease, I needed the shaping on the side. So you don't do a full bust adjustment because you need more room here as such. It's because you need the shape for the curve here on the front. So this dolman, of course, will have all this excess here, and especially this one because the sleeve opening is much wider to allow for this detail. This one has the buttons on the front. Love that, just to make a change because the original has the buttons on the back. Bias tape made with the same fabric finishes the neckline inside super neatly, and it's just a basic top. I like solids, I have some texture, that's why I've chosen this fabric, although it's not the most practical because it's sheer and I need to layer something underneath. I don't really mind because it's pretty. For this bonnie top, I was mainly interested in view B. I do like view A, but I don't think I'll be visiting that version from this pattern, at least. I love these. I think they're super pretty. They showcase nice fabric. They were easy to sew. And the fact that I did a full bust adjustment to add a dart. They have tons of ease, but there's no shaping. So you end up with all this like extra stuff here that doesn't look very nice. So I think doing it is all worth it to get a nice fit, and that's why I went through that. Let me know in the comments what your results have been with woven dolmans. I do love them. I do absolutely love them, and I like doing little things to them, hacking them. And this pattern had some hacks I would have done to other patterns that didn't have these details, like adding a button down feature or adding shoulder tabs here or adding side slit. Those are the types of things I add to patterns that don't have those details. But this one had it, so that's why I liked it and wanted to share it with you. I hope you liked this video, that you got something practical for your own sewing. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon with more sewing. Bye.